Krishna. Question: did the Pandavas go to heaven or to the spiritual world? Question, this question is from Shyam Vihari Prabhu. You mentioned in your Mahabharata classes that the Mahabharata mentioned the Pandavas went to Swarga as mentioned in the Mahabharata 18th Parva. But then they are pure devotees. Won't they go back to the spiritual world? Answer: every scripture has its particular focus, its particular purpose, and everything within that scripture is presented in harmony with that purpose. So the Bhagavatam is a book that talks about paradharma. Dharma projahita kaitavotra paramo nirmatsaranam satam. It puts aside all subordinate dharmas and focuses on the transcendental dharma. And in that sense, it is a spiritual history which takes accounts that focus on the transcendental reality, on the transcendental purpose of life, and how people can achieve that transcendental reality, ultimately Krishna. Now the Mahabharata primarily is a book of dharma, artha, kama and moksha. Its focus is on understanding what is dharma, and dharma that is understood in the Mahabharata. There is, of course, within the Mahabharata Bhagavad Gita, which gives the conclusive dharma, sarva dharma anparityaja mamekam sharanam braja, of pure devotional service. But overall, the Mahabharata is more of a world affirming book which focuses on action in this world, and it focuses on how to live in this world, not how to leave the world. Although that is also there in the Mahabharata. The Mahabharata is a huge encyclopedia, and various levels of dharma are there in it, including the highest dharma also. But the two books have different focus point and different focuses and different purposes. So with this basic understanding, we also need to know that the same incidents are described differently in the two books. So one such incident which is described differently is is the departure of the Pandavas. So in the Mahabharata, there is a whole parva which describes how the Pandavas ascend to heaven, and ultimately the Pandavas are going towards the north. All the Pandavas fall away one by one except Yudhishthir, who ultimately goes to heaven, and there he meets he goes for a few minutes to hell, and then he eventually, along with his brothers, returns to heaven. So that is a whole elaborate talk which will come in the later part of the which comes towards the end of the Mahabharata. But suffice it to say here that actually the Mahabharata describes this. The Bhagavatam describes that the Mahabharata describes Pandavas left with Draupadi. The Bhagavatam describes that the Pandavas just left, and Prabhupada talks about that, how all of us have to fly our plane alone in the purport in that section. And then it also, the Bhagavatam says that they went back to the spiritual world. So we understand that how do we understand these different narratives? There are multiple ways in which this can be understood. So first is, as I said, because they have different focuses, the standard way the Acharyas explain differences within the scripture is by talking about a hierarchy of scripture. So there is a Shastra Taratamya. Taratamya means a hierarchy of scripture. So there is a higher level scripture which is called the Nirnayak Shastra, and there is a lower level scripture which is called the Nirnayatara Shastra. So the Bhagavatam clearly is the Nirnayak Shastra. Nirnayak means the highest, that which will decide, and Nirnayatara is that which is to be decided. The Bhagavatam is written by Vyasadeva in his maturity, so that gives the conclusion. So whenever there is a conflict with the scripture, the Nirnayak Shastra is considered to be highest, but the Nirnayatara Shastra's version is reconciled, it is not rejected with the highest understanding. So we understand that the Pandavas went to the spiritual world. Now, how do we understand the Mahabharata's narrative then? the standard explanation that the acharyas give is that the this is referring to a kalpabhed, that is talking about a different age. The Mahabharata is talking about a different different time when Krishna descended, the Pandavas descended. The Bhagavatam is talking about a different time. So some stories can just have different focuses, and the same story can be understood from different perspectives. Some can be referring entirely to different millennia, different kalpas when the events happened. And Madhvacharya also says in his Mahabharata Tatpari Nirnay that the Mahabharata is interpolated. It is such a huge book that the possibility of interpolation is there. And because he says that it is interpolated so much that its conclusion is difficult to discern, so he gives the conclusion Mahabharata Tatpari Nirnay. So there is also the possibility that some stories within the Mahabharata could be interpolated. So in general, because we understand that the Bhagavatam is the highest authority, it's Shastra Tartamya, Jiva Goswami explains it as the Sarva Pramana Chakravarti Bhuta. It is the emperor among all Pramanas. So therefore, that is the Pramana that we should focus on. And we accept that Pramana's authority as the highest. So the Pandavas did go to the spiritual world. But in some other kalpa, which the Mahabharata refers to, they went to heavens. And were they not pure devotees in that kalpa? No, the point is, the Mahabharata is depicting reality in a particular way. So people who are attracted to Mahabharata, they are attracted to the lives of kings and how they struggle and how they attain success in dharma, artha, kama. So from the for the karma kandas, the success in life is to attain heaven. So when they see that the Pandavas have attained heaven, then they feel vindicated in their determination to practice karma kanda. And that is also at one level good. Yes, that is not desirable from the highest perspective of transcendence. But those who are not ready for transcendence, for them a gradual path to elevation is not just desirable but essential. So for them, the Bhagavatam depicts, the Mahabharata depicts their attainment of success of heaven. Now the Mahabharata doesn't depict what happened to them after they attained heaven. So the Mahabharata also describes that there they in heaven they saw Krishna. Now if Krishna is there, then it is not heaven, it is Vaikuntha. So now of course in heavens Krishna is present in various manifestations. He's also there as Vamana. He comes there as as the younger son of Aditi, and as Upendra, as he is called sometimes in the Vishnu Sahasranam. So the point is that the Pandavas, because they were devotees of Krishna and they remembered Krishna, even if they attain heaven, then that, because they are remembering Krishna, they are seeing, they are in the presence of Krishna, as the Bhagavatam also mentioned, as the Mahabharata mentioned. So they are in a transcendental situation, and from heaven eventually they will attain the spiritual world. So the Mahabharata is depicting is largely at a karma kanda level, and its Swarga Arohan Parva depicts success at the level of karma kanda, but it doesn't depict the ultimate reality and it doesn't depict the ultimate destination of the Pandavas. The Pandavas in some other kalpa can, by Krishna's plan, be doing the service of demonstrating karma kanda and the success of karma kanda, success in karma kanda for Lokahitam Nirpa. Loka Sangraha Meva, for setting an example for others, for those who cannot practice devotion, then at least let them practice gradual elevation to karma kanda. And that is Krishna's will. The Pandavas, as pure devotees, may demonstrate that also. In fact, the Bhagavatam also talks about this, that King Pruthu or other kings, when they were kings, they would perform karma kanda sacrifices, as was expected of kings at that time. But Vishwanath Chakrataku says that in his commentary, that in their minds, they were actually remembering that the demigods are representatives of Krishna, and they were offering all the sacrifices not to the demigods but to Krishna. So because of their inner conception, it was actually a devotional activity. But still, for the general people, often they were setting an example of doing karma kanda. So the scriptures have a multiple level plan for gradual elevation as well as rapid elevation. And we need to understand this plan carefully to understand why certain narratives are depicted in one way in one scripture and another way in another scripture.